You're a great speaker. You own the stage. You have a great message. So what?
How'd you do that?
I see that success is not something you pursue. It is something you are.
So here's the thing. I mean, you have a great message. You're a great speaker. You get on stage. You own it. But I got to tell you something that most gurus just simply will not tell you because honestly, they're not looking out for you. You see, you and I must make a pact. We must bring salvation back. Where there is love, I'll be there. I'll reach out my hand to you. I'll have faith in all you do. Just call my name and I'll be there. See, I'm going to look out for you because look, if you have a great message, it doesn't really matter if you don't know how to market yourself, if you don't know how to get on stages. If you get your speech right, then you can market it right. So your product is your speech, but you getting on stages is a result of your marketing. You need to think of yourself as the musician and as the manager to the musician. So you can have this dual personality if you want. Think in terms of, at this point, I'm going to be the musician, I'm going to be the artist, and here's how we're going to work on the speech and blah, blah, blah. Then at a certain point, you're like, all right, bam, I'm Bill Gates mode, I'm Steve Jobs mode, and we're focusing on the business side. So that's essentially what you got to do. When you combine the two, you become a Jay-Z, a 50 Cent, a Beyonce. You become the artist and the businessman. It's just like Jay-Z said, I'm not a businessman, I'm a businessman. So you want to look at your marketing materials as if you were a different person. So whatever your name, John Doe, whatever your name is, go to your website, johndoe.com, and look at your website as if you weren't that person, as if you weren't that speaker, and be completely honest with yourself. Would you hire this person? Would you pay $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 for this person? Be honest. And really, the best thing that you can do is to simply go to another speaker's website who looks like you, whose website is very similar to yours. And I mean, be honest. I mean, don't go to like Tony Robbins' site, but my site looks like his. Don't do that. Go to a website who has like, maybe if you have no videos, then go to another speaker's website who has no videos. If your text is really long, go to another speaker who has text that's really long. Go to a speaker who's similar to you in terms of what their website looks like. Then ask someone you know, a friend, a family member, say, hey, what do you think about this speaker? Would you pay $5,000, $10,000 for this speaker? Pay very close attention to what they say. I mean, they're going to say, nah, this dude looks like a scrub. And they're going to give you the honest to God truth. They won't do this if you say, hey, look at my website. What do you think about this? And the reason they won't do this is because they don't want to offend you. They don't want to say, oh, I don't want to be that guy who puts him down. I don't want to be that guy who says, nah, you can't live up to your dreams. I don't want to be that person. So they're not going to tell you the truth. So you have to go to another speaker's website and say, hey, what do you think about his site? And then whatever they're saying, they're essentially saying that about you. I mean, be honest with yourself. Would you hire you? Listen, you might have a great message. You might be a great speaker, but you got to stop focusing on you and focus on them. Focus on looking from their perspective in terms of how they hire speakers, what they look for, what has to go on your website for them to make that decision. Focus on them, not you. When I get these emails where speakers say, I have a great presentation, I'm a great speaker, but I just need to get on more stages. It all comes down to the marketing. You gotta learn the marketing. If you are a great speaker, if you have a great presentation, master the marketing.